Hey guys, let's continue this game. Hopefully I manage to finish this tonight. Let's just keep on whipping, or this evening. Yeah, not sure if we want to do that. But there's also some kind of synergy thing. With our unique building, we can get some super priests. With obelisks, so these guys are all will get one extra hammer. Not too useful Let's just keep on whipping some. Let's keep whipping our key buildings. Some more production. I'll try to play a little bit quicker, but as stated earlier, I have to be real careful about playing too quick. So, next turn. Yeah, we are definitely going for the capital, I think. We can almost guaranteed take that capital next turn. Oh, and we forgot to leave a unit. Send these guys to the front. An explorer. You can actually pick up a road on that tower and have some kind of faster entry to that city. And yeah, we finally finished the last cottage for this city. So it's not too impressive on food actually, or it is, but we'll be able to grow into, yeah, we'll grow into all the parcels. Will take some time. And sure, let's hook up some more stone. We'll try to put these guys in a position for an attack. Probably check if he would capitulate before we moved our units. But okay. And we heard a ding. Great profit. Brennus, why don't you go for something? Maybe paper? Can't really trade with him. Going to get paper probably. Going to get theology from Hammurabi. So let's send this guy to. Yeah. I guess music? We're going to keep growing. Yeah, let's just work all the mines. We are. Oh, let's try to pick up the last thing. And I think we will try to use this section and go straight into this. Get a little bit quicker movement for this city, I think. But yeah, next turn. Yeah, I kind of expected that. And yeah, we're getting 9 promotion and 9 experience trebuchets straight out of the gate. That's pretty nice. That's not going to help you too much. Just a little bit too late. So we will probably just bombard both and sack a ton of units into that city. So let's just go like this and send in. Probably have to do this in a little bit the right order. Just wasting some cheap units first. Hopefully we are not getting too much war weariness. Yeah, he has the Statue of Zeus, but it is in Babylon, so it kind of makes sense to also go for Babylon. Let's see, let's maybe upgrade the. What type of units actually makes 40%? We screw up right now. We have that one crossbowman, and then we are going to meet Mace. So, what kind of unit is making 40% in the attack? Can't really understand. Is it one of these guys? No. One of these guys? No. No. Yeah, that's strange. Is it the elephant? Yeah, it's the elephant. Okay. Not so strange. Yeah, we probably screwed up a little bit. I think we have to wait for the trebuchets. But on a good note, we did waste off a lot of units, so now we don't need any gold. So that's nice. In a really backhanded way. So. One more turn. Yeah, that was a dumb attack. should have been thinking a little bit more about it, but do actually want to waste some units. Considering our position, so it's not the end of the world. But now, yeah, what the hell? That's really bad. That's probably the one city we do not want to have that stuff in. Okay. Let's try to be a little bit more cost efficient in this attack. Yeah. Come on. Well, okay. I think we got it. Yeah, we do. Yeah, we got a little bit too greedy there. Should have waited one turn on more reinforcement. But then again, we did save a lot in unit maintenance. Which sounds just dumb. Since we want to produce units, let's use this one. And here is it. Couple of nice wonders and a really low food city. No, he will not capitulate. To grab this city next turn. So let's find stuff to go, and next turn I think we should be able to attack the city. Definitely have a lot of units in range. And yeah. Whoops. Can move one pike back, so let's do that. Kind of guarantee that we don't lose the city to this horse archer. Let's prepare for a road. And okay, do we pull Mehmed off him? I think that's how's the chances that the Hammurabi will capitulate him? They're actually pretty good since he lost the city. Ooh. Yeah. And giving him both of those techs Really sucks. But then again, if he won't capitulate next turn to us, we capitulate in Mehmed, we will be in attacking position again quick, and we'll just take his new capital. And yeah, we will be delayed, but I think it's yeah, I think we can risk waiting. It will really suck if he capitulates next turn to Mehmed, but yeah. Overall, I think it's better. So, do not capitulate. Nice. Yeah, and it took out some stuff from us. Will he capitulate? No. But he will give away a nice religion. What did he kill? Oh yeah, he killed a trebuchet. It's fine. This will be easy. Yeah, you see those guys, they are competing against they are competing on metal units this late in the game. And perfect. He still has a lot of units left. I think we should just heal. Now have possibility to build. yeah, we're not going to build the AP. And I think our next target. It's pretty obvious it's going to be Mehmed. Keep fighting the good war. We'll need some healing. But yeah, it will be okay. Pick up some happiness. I'm also thinking about giving his cities back. There aren't really going to be any use. We'll whip out a chariot in this city. But even though we're losing a lot of good stuff over here, we probably want to keep this city. But let's give back here this one. Oof. 6 turns. It's not going to be enough time in the game that the Babylon will be useful for him, not for us. So I think the most important thing is just getting out some. And yeah, here's our scientist. So this will be really cool actually. But okay, we'll give back Babylon, Dur, Kasul, and we'll keep Akkad and Sippur. That will make sure that he has borders against Mehmed in all ways. I always have borders against him. And we'll just go and take out Mehmed really quick. So Babylon, we'll give it back. I know we are giving away the great library bu city, but that's okay. There we go. We stay. Look at this culture board that I got back. And Dur Kasul. Also give him some research power. I guess we'll just keep this city. It's almost breaking even, so sure. Is there any way we can pick up a map from someone? Let's give him ivory. Yeah, it has all the other stuff, so sure. Any of this guy? Okay. This guy we can move. And yeah. Macemen and knights. So we are just going to heal our units, wait for him to do something stupid in this city, and go in s and completely smash his guys. Think we want to finish guilds now. Make some knights on our, of our ourselves. Yeah, probably even grab a maceman or two. Probably not going to get a new, another great scientist. Or we can at least try. So we are back to unit production again. Let's just get out a couple of these guys. Notre Dame, no. Macemen, yes. We need maces and we need some knights. So, yes. Horse archer. They're always focusing on getting out that spy. I don't know why. But this city, we'll probably need to get a market for our holy shrine. Hammurabi, you can research. Guess paper? We'll need paper. Probably not going to get it from anyone else. So, here we go. And yeah, we forgot about that night. Yes.
People of the same trade seldom meet together, even for merriment and diversion, but the conversation ends in a conspiracy against the public.
Yeah, we want to heal up our army. Any revolt chance? Yeah, pretty high revolt chance. Was a little bit afraid of that. Chance in this city? No. Did we lose our vision guy? I think so. Let's make another. Find out what this guy's cooking. Let's just heal this guy. And this is 19 gold per turn. Guess it's okay. We are breaking even in our gold production. Let's get out more units. Farms, sure. Maybe we should just start attack. Right now. No, we want to heal. Definitely stop all the priests. Whip. Maceman. Why are you running that when you can get one extra hammer? We'll never know. Pick up some gold. Do not think he will attack us, even though he's annoyed. He's plotting. So, there's actually a chance that it's against us. So that's pretty bad news. Let's just send some units up there fast. Whip. Yeah, this city, even though it's pretty bad, has been generating a unit or two for the longest time. So that's really nice. Get some more knights going. Yeah, it would be really bad if he attacked us. But I don't think he will attack someone double their size with two vassals. That seems a little bit too ambitious. We'll get some markets going, get a market going, and then we'll see. There's one knight. Keep making knights, I guess. Trebuchet, we can whip next turn. Another knight. Yeah, we kind of have to be on this micromanagement level still. Yes. Getting a little bit lower reroll chances, but that's okay. Okay. So we will just go Nippur, give it back, then grab the next city. And we're not upgrading our swordmen because we don't need to. Let's get a longbowman. I don't want to leave this city. If we get... He is going for us. Come on. Stupid Ragnar. Well, okay. If he's attacking us, we'll just have to crush him. So that's fine as well. Oh, that's so stupid. Ragnar, come on. Anything else? He's still annoyed. Is there anything we can do to stop him from attacking next turn? I'm almost positive that it's us he's going for, so let's just be prepared to take out this, take him out really quick. We want to have a unit in position to retake this city. Kind of not that big of a difference if you take out Ragnar or Mehmed first, but it's just annoying that he's forcing us to take him. Hopefully we'll be able to take out a couple of units. He has some really promoted berserkers. Those going to be a pain. Yeah, we probably lost the city and right after we settled that holy shrine. That's pretty bad, but okay. Can't really do anything. Here's a unit. We have to now. We have to keep a close eye on units because his unit will jump back, probably on one of these things. Let's see. Stop trading with Ragnar. No, can't. We cannot. And yeah, let's just grab this thing. Finally, some would say. And we'll get out the scientist or something and run a golden age. 12 turn golden age. Well, okay, stupid Ragnar, attack. Oh. He didn't attack. Well. That's a lot better. Let's grab a 2-turn trebuchet. Yeah, I'm not too impressed with this actually. 150 production. It's still taking some time to produce. Did we scare him away? If he's going for Justin, that is good as well. And I think by having these units in the city, definitely have stopped him from like the first wave. So let's see how much do we hate Justin. He's cautious. Mehmed, what is he taking? Yeah, Mehmed has gunpowder. Yeah, maybe it is smarter for us to just go for Ragnar real quick. He will have a rough time attacking the city. And we can keep whipping out longbows. So, and we can get on top of this tile. And then we'll be an attack range. Within a couple of turns. Yeah, let's take out Ragnar real quick. He will probably fall real quick as well. Let's see. Guilds for music, sure.
Music be the food of love. Play on.
We need some culture in this city. So yeah. Okay, so there's Istanbul. Yeah, and probably going to attack in two turns. We'll hold build up some more defenses here. Just stack a lot of longbowmen or something into the city and soak up his attacking force, and then we'll go around the back and just snipe off cities. So we might just do Ragnar, then go for Justin, and it's possibly that we don't even attack Mehmed. We'll see. Ten turns, we'll start our golden age. Maybe we can do it even quicker. Probably be a little bit quicker if we make a priest. Golden age will be really nice when we have this many cities. They are pretty whipped, but okay, nice. A But okay, let's try to play a little bit quicker. That's time. Yeah, we did accomplish some stuff. We capitulated Hammurabi. We decided on who we are going to attack next. And that's pretty much it. Speedrun points on Memon. But yeah, we'll continue this in the next episode. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon.